Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Good morning, colleagues. Mr. Speaker, if you will permit me, just prior to speaking on the motion before us, to first congratulate all musicians on the celebration of St. Cecilia's Day. I also want to take the opportunity, as we're speaking, with regards to musicians, to also congratulate, Mr. Speaker, a group from my community, Schozel Musical Symphony Orchestra, program that was launched on Sunday, primarily made up of very young people who will be learning to play various instruments, Mr. Speaker, and I'm happy that the Ministry of Education has supported that program going forward to make it a sort of an after-school program to encompass all children from the community, Mr. Speaker. I also want, Mr. Speaker, to take the opportunity to thank and to congratulate all the volunteers who are coming forward to provide the expertise in terms of teaching the young children, Mr. Speaker. It is, you know, extremely heartening in the environment that we live to recognize people who give up their time, their resources, to come forward and to help our young people and our community. And as I'm speaking on volunteerism, Mr. Speaker, I also want to take the time out to thank the members of the Lamaze Congregation of Seventh Day, who also came out from a voluntary perspective, Mr. Speaker, to clean up their community, which they found, Mr. Speaker, was very unsightly and not, you know, conducive for, you know, traversing. In addition, Mr. Speaker, we have had a program going on for the past couple of Sundays where young people from the community were engaged, particularly from a group called DROL, which is a shortened form to recognize three communities, Dibrel, Rublo, and Lamaze, where they've been coming out, Mr. Speaker, to try to patch up the very rough roads that they have to travel to go home, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I also want to express my sympathy to the young lady who lost her life this morning. It is always difficult to hear of the passing of anyone, particularly by violent means, and especially, Mr. Speaker, when you've had some interaction with the individual, it is even more, you know, stressful, Mr. Speaker. You know, I want to sympathize with her family, the medical fraternity, a young daughter, Mr. Speaker, and I want, Mr. Speaker, to ensure the Prime Minister, as I've told him before, that he has my full support as it relates, Mr. Speaker, doing whatever is necessary to ensure that we stop that scourge, Mr. Speaker. I would like to encourage, Mr. Speaker, that we, you know, create an atmosphere where people believe that there are consequences, because I believe one of the reasons why a lot of people do what they do is because they believe the absence of consequences, particularly when, you know, there seems to be a slap on the wrist. I know that's outside of our sphere, Mr. Speaker. A lot of that has to do with the system that we operate in, Mr. Speaker. But we all need to be on the same page to ensure that we discourage such behavior. Mr. Speaker, on the motion before us, I was actually very delighted to hear the Honorable Prime Minister speak to the devastating effects of COVID-19, Mr. Speaker, on our country, on the world, Mr. Speaker, and to recognize that even a year and some months later, we are still, looking at providing assistance for people who have been affected by COVID-19. And that is why, Mr. Speaker, I was always a bit discouraged when we were in government and there was a continuous bashing by this government of the borrowing, Mr. Speaker, because I have continuously said it is a necessity of government to borrow, Mr. Speaker. And we would have known that during COVID, everything stopped running. No revenue was coming in, Mr. Speaker, but government had to continue to operate. which included, you know, paying civil servant salaries, addressing the pain of our bonds, Mr. Speaker. Because had we not done these things, because St. Lucia would have had a credibility problem. You know, we could have been downgraded. So many effects, Mr. Speaker, that could have spiraled out of control had we not borrowed, Mr. Speaker. And a lot of the money that we borrowed, Mr. Speaker, went into budgetary support, which, Mr. Speaker, was well known by everybody. But sometimes, you know, Mr. Speaker, the politics come into play and we create certain things which you should not create, Mr. Speaker. So borrowing is a necessary evil by governments, Mr. Speaker. And I agree that as opposition, as members of the public, government must be kept on their toes as it relates to what we borrow for. But I can say, Mr. Speaker, that what we borrowed for under the COVID times was really and truly was to ensure that St. Lucia did not go into the sort of deep hole, you know, that COVID could have created, Mr. Speaker. So I'm happy, Mr. Speaker, particularly that $14 million is being borrowed this morning, particularly geared towards the vulnerable. And I will make a case this morning to the Minister of Equity to not to forget various groups in our communities, and I speak to the Club 60 in particular in my community, a group which takes care of senior citizens who cannot cook food and other social activities that they engage in, Mr. Speaker, who've had a lot of their resources, you know, stopped for one reason or the other. While we were in office, you know, we did provide some assistance, and I'm hoping that, you know, that sort of intervention from the Ministry of Equity would continue to recognize such entities who provide, you know, significant work in the communities. So I look forward to that sort of community sharing of the resources, Mr. Speaker. But, Mr. Speaker, the Prime Minister made one statement I just want to bring to his attention. He said that we on this side were contacted to add names to the list. Mr. Prime Minister, I have not been contacted. I don't know if it's something that will come, but I have not been contacted with regards to adding names to I have never been contacted to adding names to a vulnerable list. So, If that may have been an oversight, I would think, because when it comes to the vulnerable, the sick, the shut-in, the senior citizens who cannot fare for themselves, we should never make that a partisan issue, Mr. Speaker. And therefore, I look forward to that correction being made. I thank you, Mr. Speaker.